Hi there! In this tutorial I'm going to show you how to create a minimalist, geometric poster design using only Adobe Illustrator. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe and leave a like, it'll motivate me to create and share more designs. Once in Illustrator, we're going to open a new document, preferably in A3 format, so as to have a work plan in the right format. Using the rectangle tool, we'll draw a shape on top of our work surface of the same size, in dark gray. Then, by pressing Ctrl+2, I'm going to lock it so that it doesn't get in the way when I manipulate my layers. Here's how to create a geometric shape with multiple lines. We'll start by creating our first shape using the feather tool. We'll invert our background color and trace so as to have a white line and a black background. We'll draw the first distorted line, which needs to be sinusoidal to create a wave effect. Then we'll draw a second line, which we'll place lower down but on top of the first. From now on, we'll use the blend mode option. Then we click on the first line we've drawn and then on the second. This will create a new shape between the two selected lines. This is an intermediate shape resulting from the merging of our two lines. Now we want to multiply our effect, so let's Alt+Left-click on one of our two lines. This will open the gradient options panel. In step, we'll choose steps and set the value next to it. This will increase the number of blending steps between our two lines. For me, this will be 60, so it's up to you to adapt it to your needs. But above all, experiment with other values and shapes. If we're satisfied, we click OK. We can always return to this panel in the same way as before. I'm going to rework my lines a little to give my shape the look I want. To simplify handling, we can group our shape by pressing Ctrl+G. I'll then place my shape on my work surface and resize it. Using Alt+Left-click to drag and drop, I'll duplicate my shape and move it to the side. By selecting my new shape and holding down the R key, I'll rotate it. I'll then move it over the first shape and right-click to go to Layout and select Back. This will move my shape below the other one. I'm going to rework it a little. From now on, I'm going to add circles to my composition. To do this, I'll use the Ellipse tool. To draw a perfect circle, I'll hold down the Ctrl key and draw my circle with the left click held down, giving it the size I want. We're now going to make a color gradient in our circle. To do this, I'm going to import the color range I want to use. You can find the option in Window, then Color Gradient. We'll select our circle and in the Gradient panel we'll click on the box with the gradient to apply it. To modify the colors, click on the small circle that appears below the gradient line. Then select the eyedropper icon just below it and select the desired color. We'll do the same for the second circle of our gradient. To add a color to our gradient, simply click just below the gradient line, which will add a new point to modify. Once our gradient is finished, we can position our circle in our composition. To add depth, I'm going to apply a drop shadow to it. To do this, select my circle and go to Effect, then Special, and Drop Shadow. We'll be able to set our drop shadow as we like in the new panel that opens. Once we're satisfied, we confirm. I'm going to add several circles to my composition, so with an Alt+Left-click, drag and drop, I'm going to duplicate and move my circle where I want it. I'll continue adding circles and adjusting them as I wish. Once I've finished with my circles, I'll import an abstract organic shape. If you'd like to make some, I invite you to follow my video tutorial on my channel, or you can also download 30 vector shapes for free. The link is in the description. Once imported, I'll position it where I want. I'm going to duplicate this shape and put it on its side. I'd like my organic shape to be inside my black shape, so I'll select my line and copy and paste it. Using the feather tool, I'll bring my two points together to close my shape. Then I'll remove its outline color. I'll then place it in the same place it was and place it below in the circle. To do this, I use the shortcut ATL plus Shift plus Control plus Q a number of times until it's under my two circles. Then, selecting the shape I've placed above, I click on the Draw Inside button here and Control plus V to copy my organic shape directly inside. Then all I have to do is select and reposition it. Again, I'll copy and paste the shape with the multiplied lines and remove its background color. Then I'll reposition it on top of the shape containing my organic form. From here, I'm going to add details to my compositions. I'm going to create a circle pattern with only a white outline. To do this, we'll use the Ellipse tool. I'll duplicate this circle with an Alt plus Shift plus left click, drag and drop and move it to wherever I want. Holding down the Shift key moves it to the same alignment. To duplicate it and repeat the same operation, I simply press Ctrl plus D several times. This will simply repeat the last action we performed. We're going to repeat the same operation, but this time selecting our circle line. Once we've created our circle pattern, I'll use the selection tool to retrieve part of the pattern I want and copy and paste it. I'll do a Ctrl plus G to group them and place them where I like. We'll repeat the same operation. But this time, once positioned, I'll add points to my circles with the feather tool and delete the part of the circle I don't want to keep. This will give the impression that our pattern is hidden beneath our shape. Using the feather tool, I'll create a line and place it in different parts of my composition. Once finished, all we have to do is reposition all our shapes and export our poster. And here's the final result. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to contact me. I'll be happy to help. If you liked this video, please subscribe and leave a like. It will motivate me to create more tutorials of my creations. See you on the channel.